This Sunday, John Paul II and the man known as Good Pope John will be proclaimed saints in Rome. Our Craig Harney will be there in the Vatican for the ceremony and tells us how these men were chosen.
To the world, John Paul II is a no-brainer for sainthood. The man who teamed with Reagan and Thatcher to help bring about the fall of communism was first proposed spontaneously in St. Peter's Square on April 2nd, 2005.
The tens of thousands that were gathered in St. Peter's Square when they heard the announcement that John Paul had died, they immediately went into El Santo, El Santo, the saint, the saint.
Bishop Gregory Hartmeyer says that the outpouring for John Paul is indeed one of the indicators that a person is worthy of sainthood in the eyes of the church.
The people were attracted to this person. That was another visible sign that people wanted to hear this person speak.
Pope John XXIII is the other man to be proclaimed a saint on Sunday. At the time of his election in 1958, good Pope John was not expected to create the sea changes that he did.
John XXIII was chosen as a caretaker pope at the age of 76.
Under John XXIII, the Latin Mass was replaced by the local tongue. The priests, for the first time, faced the congregation instead of the altar, and music flourished, as did the fortunes of good Pope John.
John XXIII's papacy only lasted 5 years, but the impact is still being felt in the church today.
This Sunday in Rome, another man who seems on the path to sainthood will make it official for two of his predecessors. And good Lord willing, I'll be trying to elbow my way toward a selfie with Pope Francis, too. Craig Harney, WTOC News.
There are 13 American saints, but only three were born on American soil. And guess what? All three are women. Watch this weekend as our series continues from Rome.